Hi guys, I'm Dr. Madhvi Bharadwaj. Let's start with introductions, okay? So I have done my graduation from Lady Harding Medical College and post-graduation from Maulana Azad Medical College. That is the place where I did my senior residency from. And now I have this, challenging task in front of me to guide you people, prepare you people better for your PG entrance examinations with pediatrics. So I'll be taking up pediatrics at this platform called ACE exam. Huh. So today I'm going to talk about my own journey. I was in the same boat as you guys are right now a few years back. And to tell you the truth, I was not very clear as to, by the end of my internship, I didn't know which subject I want to pursue for the rest of my life. But I was pretty sure surgery is not for me. Okay, so I knew if I want to take medical fields, I have to, score really well. I started studying with internship only. I was studying, reading up the notes they give, the notes we prepare in coaching classes that we join usually in third year itself. So yes, I had those notes, I had those MCQs books which we all read, and 10 years and everything. But my result was not very great, I would say. I cleared most of my exams, but the ranks were nowhere near where I wanted them to be. So in first go, I picked up pathology at PGI Chandigarh, okay? Under a lot of pressure, obviously, but my heart was not into it. I did not pursue it. I decided to give myself a chance. So I sat back and I decided to prepare again. I gave myself that 1 year. And now I'm really happy that I did, because whatever I'm doing today makes me happy. So let's go back. So that 1 year, before starting my preparation, I actually, went inside, introspected, and thought, what went wrong? What was not up to the mark? What was the difference between that girl, who cleared in first attempt? What was I doing? So it is not about number of attempts you give yourself. That is what I realized. It's about the kind of reading, the kind of, quality time you're giving your subject and your studies. Three things which I think changed my game. Three things which I think helped me big time in achieving whatever I did today. In my second attempt, I cleared AIIMS. It was rank 40. I don't actually remember most of my ranks. I picked up gynae there. Again, a surgical subject, but yes, ophtha, ENT and other subjects were definitely not my choice. So I did gynae there for 1.5 months. By the time my All India or NEET, ours was the first batch to give NEET examination. So by the time NEET exam ka result came, and I knew my rank is good enough, that will give me medicine, peds, anything I wanted, I actually left AIIMS. When you see my videos, when you see me teaching, actually my mnemonics would sound very weird to you. My way of teaching would be weird, but actually they've stayed with me till this time. Because I've given it a body, I've given it a structure, concept building. There's some weird things. Usually a disease has clinical presentation, then it comes with certain signs, and then the x-ray fine investigation and treatment. It already has a body. You just have to see it, conceptualize it. So most of the topics that we read, they have concepts behind them. We are the ones who, in our hurried attitude, we do superficial reading, mug them up, and just before the exam, we forget it. Or thoda sa bhi idhar udhar kuch question aata hai, some option in the MCQ is there which is slightly confusing. That question is then all confused and gone for us. All the topics, I tell you, all the topics which you don't like, which give you creeps, topics you dread, make a list of those topics and give them maximum time. Give them time, sit with them and do them thoroughly. And the best way to know whether you know this topic correctly or not is teach it. Teach it to a junior or a friend of yours or a colleague, anybody who's studying with you. It could be anyone. And if you can make that topic, you know, easy or understandable to that other fellow, your job is done. Then you know this topic. ओके एनीथिंग कुछ भी घुमा फिरा के कहीं से भी कोई क्वेश्चन अगर उसके बारे में आता है आई एम श्योर यू विल नॉट लूज दैट क्वेश्चन ओके आई रिमेंबर फ्लूइड एसिड बेस बैलेंस जेनेटिक्स नाउ दैट वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट पीडियाट्रिक्स दीज यूज टू बी माय वीक पॉइंट्स ओके आई यूज टू ड्रेड दीज सब्जेक्ट्स इवन इन पोस्ट ग्रेजुएशन ओके बट वन डे आई डिसाइडेड दैट ये मेरे को पढ़ना है और मैं अपने जूनियर्स को यही टॉपिक पढ़ाऊंगी ओके दिस वॉज माई सेकेंड ईयर And that is one day and today. I think ABG analysis is one of my favorite topics. Okay? So the topics you don't like, the topics you dread, take them up and do them really well. You know, they'll stay with you forever. Okay? Master them. One thing. Secondly, this some senior of mine suggested and I think it was a excellent suggestion. In exam, the questions don't come in sections, no? 15 questions pediatrics, 5 questions from obs gyne, 10 from medicine. It doesn't come like that. Do they? No, they don't. Okay. One question comes from forensic, next is from surgery, third is from anatomy, then it goes back to medicine. You know, so when you are preparing, you should prepare in a similar way. Okay. Don't sit with one particular subject or one particular topic for months or weeks. Okay. Make your timetable in such a way, morning or if you are doing it with your college time, you are posted in pediatrics. Okay, when you are posted there, 2 to 3 hours of, you know, same subject, come back, do 2 hours of forensic, night, do 2 hours of some other subject, probably physiology. Okay, so that by the end of 1 month, 3 of your important subjects are covered. Okay, so keep jogging your brain just the way you have to do an exam. Okay. And thirdly, everybody tells you this. बहुत ही घिसी पटी एडवाइस है बट आई थिंक इट इज़ वन ऑफ द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट एडवाइस इज टाइम योर सेल्फ ओके ट्राई स्टिकिंग टू योर टाइम लाइन्स ओके योर एग्जाम इज ऑल अबाउट योर टाइम मैनेजमेंट एंड योर नॉलेज ओके वॉट देयर टेस्टिंग इज इन दिस यू नो ड्यूरेशन ऑफ टाइम वॉट ऑल यू कैन अचीव 3 hours the same to all the kids sitting there to give the exam, yes. But only a few make magic in those 3 hours and change their life. So remember, don't read, learn, okay? Make your concepts. If you can't, if you get stuck in a subject, seek help. We are there to help you, okay? Your seniors, your college faculty, we at, you know, ACE exam, we all are there to help you, okay? So seek help. Then time yourself and yes, very important. Do multiple topics during a certain time, you know, time frame. So let's conclude this little talk with a very important, I would say, feeling. So your journey starts the day, the minute, the second you decide to do it. Don't wait. Start it. And if you need help, we're always there. Take us along. We at ACE exam know what it takes to be there. I remember when we were students, MAMSI was written on one of the tables we used to study in. Those were non-COVID times, so obviously ours used to be a classroom session and not a, you know, virtual session like we're having right now. So the table had MAMSI etched on it. And I asked one of my friends, what is so glamorous, what is so classy about MAMSI? Why do you want to go to MAMSI? Okay, so my friend told me, when you go there, probably then you'll know. Okay, so yes, when I went there, I knew. And when I look back, I realized that, yes, my journey was worth it. So we at ACE exam know what it takes to be there. It's that feeling, been there, done it. So if you need our help, we are always there, okay? Let's do this together. Let's make your life a little easy. Let's make your dreams come true and do it real good.